Regarding the Helicobacter pylori infection, this is also an important point in the pediatric gastroenterology field because H. pylori could drive the occurrence of gastritis or other condition of, at the stomach level, and selected probiotic strain, in particular Saccharomyces boulardii, Lactobacillus rhamnosus GG, would improve the efficacy of the eradication therapy, in other words, the effect of antibiotics, and at the same time, the use of this probiotic could limit the adverse events occurrence induced by the antibiotic course. So we can have an advantage in terms of efficacy of the therapeutic strategy and in terms of protection against adverse events. And also in this case, it has been clearly demonstrated that 1 week of treatment, combination therapy with antibiotics and proton pump inhibitors plus a probiotic could have a positive effect in terms of therapeutic efficacy and safety. This is a clear example of a well-established use of probiotics against gastrointestinal infection in the pediatric age and not only in the pediatric age. Many other indications in pediatric gastroenterology are emerging, but at this time the level of evidence is quite low. So we need more evidence, because one thing is to have a clear evidence in the basic science background. I can show you that this particular strain could exert a positive effect on cell line of an animal model. One thing is to use exactly the same probiotics in humans, in babies, to prevent or to treat a particular condition. In this case, you should be very prudent. It's very important to wait for clinical evidence deriving from randomized controlled trials, and we need at least a couple of randomized controlled trials that could be included in a meta-analysis. At the end of the history, we can reach the top of the evidence. In other words, you can include this probiotic in a guideline to drive the use of this probiotic strain in pediatric gastroenterology in the pediatric field. The problem that we have now is that about 0.5% of the products available on the market in Europe, as well as United States, are full out of control. There is no low quality, low controls level in terms of quality of the product. Of the effective presence of the strain could be a problem. It would be a limiting step. In other words, I'm buying in the pharmacy a particular strain, and I'm getting home another strains. I'm buying, I don't know, 1 billion bacteria, and I'm receiving, I don't know, 100 bacteria only. And this is a problem, because it's time to create a sort of agency able to control the quality of this product that are available on the market, and the stability of this product. Because one thing is to have a clear evidence in the clinical practice, and one thing is to buy every day this compound. Now this is an important problem, because this is an explosion of the probiotic market in the Western world. Everybody wants to buy probiotic, and in particular case, we can buy the wrong bacteria, we can use the wrong dose, and we can have wrong and particular, sometimes dangerous clinical effect. So it's time to create another level of the quality of the product available on the market, in terms of, and this could increase our level of safety when I would like to prescribe a probiotic. This is another important problem, because the auto-prescription rate is increasing among the European consumers. Many families to the pharmacies buying probiotic product without a clear evidence of the efficacy. And this could be another important problem. So it's time to stay within a perfect control by physicians, by agency, to drive the use of this compound, this product in, for the consumers living in Europe as well as in other parts of the world.